Yo, what's going on, guys? JBH here, and welcome back to MLB The Show 18 for this final game in this three-game series against the Atlanta Braves. Last time out, the last video I uploaded, we managed to get a win in what was a 3-0 shutout in what was an incredibly pitched, well-pitched game by Robert Gsellman. Today, the series is tied after an 8-4 loss yesterday. I didn't actually play that match. I simulated that game, so that was the computer losing, not me. Excuses. But today we have the big man Noah Syndergaard on the mound, so hopefully he can pitch us to another win. As you can see, he's 3-1 this year with an ERA of 1.71. Alrighty, without any further ado, we'll head down to CiTi Field and get this show on the road.
MLB The Show has baseball on tap from lovely CiTi Field in Flushing, Queens.
Today, the third and final game in this three-game series between the Atlanta Braves and the New York Mets. It's Mets baseball on the show. Next. Noah Syndergaard gets the ball for the Mets in this one. What's your take on him, Dan?
Hey, in this day and age where we're all into numbers and statistics, look at this whip, 1.10 or less. He has a sub 1.1. That's not an easy thing to do, especially in today's game where we see teams scoring a lot of runs. He doesn't walk very many guys, and he doesn't give up that many hits either. This is a real good pitcher and should be fun to watch pitch in this one.
Stepping in for the Braves, Ender Inciarte. And as you can tell easily from the splits, he's really struggled.
Alrighty, here we go. Opening pitch. Thursday baseball.
Here's the first pitch to
him.
Here
we go.
0-1 the count. These Mets fellas, as they take the field here today, they come in scuffling a bit of late, just 2-4 over their last six games.
Yeah, Matty, this is the big one right here. They split the first two games of this series. You want to steal one right here and be feeling good about yourself.
Yeah, Dero, I think one of the things you want to do, you get to the third game, you'd like to win this series and finish it off by winning game three.
Yes.
It's always nice.
All right, one down.
Whether it's at home or on the road, so this is a big one for this ball club.
And now a moment to show you the lineup for Atlanta in this one. Mark, what's your take on him against one of the best starters in the game?
Yeah, Matty, this lineup likes to run the bases. They like to run them aggressively. Stolen bases are not out of the equation. Taking the extra bag, putting the defense on blast right here. The key for this offense is getting guys on base to create havoc.
Here's Nick Markakis now, the right fielder. And he's looking to turn things around. Ice cold at the plate in recent action.
2-19. Wow, that is a slump. Alrighty, here we go. Two pitches leads to the first out.
A changeup
on the bottom.
The bottom of the zone for a strike. Career numbers versus Syndergaard. He's 3-9. Wow, that grounder got him.
Come on, go, go, go. Wait, why am I not
safe at first?
I was
good effort to recover.
That was weird.
There,
I was
made the play,
playing as the
as the
catcher instead
right
of should
have.
Okay, that was weird. Look, you can see me go running off. It should have automatically changed me to the pitcher. That was stupid.
It is, D-Roy, and you can read that right off the bat as a pitcher. You can read the angle. You know that that ball is going to be hit on the ground, and you're thinking deep down inside, okay, there's a quick out, and it just wasn't meant to be.
Here's the first baseman, Freddie Freeman. First shot for him here with a runner at first now and one away. The 0-1 pitch. And that sinker misses at the shoe tops. Ball one. Time for a look at our umpires in this one. Behind the plate is Patrick Johnson.
Yeah, Dan, we got Patrick Johnson behind the dish tonight. Fairly standard strike zone most of the time, but he's definitely a pitcher's umpire.
I always felt like this. He'll give a little bit on the
corners.
Oh, my
God, way
inside
outside.
And outside. I think he's a fair umpire, but I would rate him more as a pitcher's umpire than a hitter's umpire.
So the Mets in real life had a pretty decent start to the season. 17-9 last time I checked. We actually beat the Padres the other day by, like, I think it was 12 runs or something ridiculous. So it's not been too bad a start. We did go on a massive win streak, and then we had a little bit of a issue. Oh, my God.
Will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
Hey, a little top of the order lightning right here, Dan. The second and third guys in the batting order throw knocks out there, and now you're staring a monster in the face.
D-Row, this is just what you don't want to face as a pitcher, right?
We're in trouble.
You get the two and three hole guys up, and all of a sudden now it's 4, 5, and 6.
Oh, come on.
Have to get through the meat of this tough batting order.
Tyler Flowers comes on with one away as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0. Now the 1-0 is taken for ball two.
What happened there? Come on.
And he'll lay the fastball in here.
Oh,
to get
that could have been called a that could have been called a ball, actually.
Well, clearly
that was close.
This guy doesn't need many warm-up pitches because he's 98 miles an hour in the first inning. Newsflash to the offense: they better get it going.
Two balls and two strikes now to the Braves catcher.
Hey, I'm a little shocked right there. Double play situation. He doesn't go with the sinker. He goes with the ordinary fastball in that situation.
Now a swing and he pops him up. And I believe, yes, the umpire signaling for the infield fly rule.
Batting fifth, second baseman, Ozzie Albies.
Now at the plate, Ozzie Albies. Great chance to drive in a run here in the early going. Comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch.
Wow. Really mistiming these. Cannot get these where I want them to be.
Two men are on with two men out. Now the 1-1 pitch. Grounded down the third baseline. But this will get fouled. It's a ball and two strikes. The 1-2. And it's fouled away.
Yeah, I think that's the idea, Matt. But he might spin to win if he starts looking for it in there.
Yes, come on, get there. Oh, what are you?
Will not be caught. It's a foul ball.
Hey, I'm biased to the hitter right now. Keep frustrating that pitcher. Foul 12 of these things off. He's going to miss over the heart of the plate at some point.
Wow, that was stupid. It's weird. I sort of started moving slowly towards it because I was sprinting towards it. So I sort of backed off on the analog stick a bit, and then I ended up
lifted the other way
stay
down
in the
left
field.
And this will wind
and
up
then as I released
ball.
It, he stopped running altogether, so it was almost like, wow. It's so hard to control these fielders on this game.
Well, this is a foul
still
ball.
Battling
this
away.
Count holds steady at 1-2.
7 foul balls in a row. Okay, come on now. This is getting a ridiculous.
Fucking kidding me.
Meanwhile, this ball gets down. It's a base hit. And this will not be
God
close.
Damn it, he should have been out. I cannot
easily.
Believe it. Another fucking fielding error, and we're down by one.
Right there. He threw everything but the kitchen sink, and he was still able to get an RBI base hit.
And Dan, I can't tell you, the longer the ABs go, usually, I'll tell you, you get in that swing mode where if he throws the rosin bag, you're pulling the trigger on it. Wait for him to settle in his zone and not come outside of it and end up getting a knock.
1-1 the count now. Runners at the corners, two
God,
men
this
out.
Sucks. It's been our story all year so far. We keep making stupid errors. Oh, my God.
Line drive, base hit.
What are you... Ah, pick up the damn ball.
As they take a 2-0 lead.
Fucking hell.
Scoring position with two away. Digging in the swing.
God,
hitter,
this is stupid.
And now the Braves look to put more across the plate.
One of them misses it, and the next one freaking doesn't pick up the ball.
Hey, as a former infielder, nothing.
God, these guys need to go back to college.
Behind your pitchers. Let's see if this guy can pick them up right here.
Fouled off.
Another thing I forgot to mention as well, I have actually gone up on the pitching difficulty. I've gone to, I think it's Hall of Fame.
Here it comes.
That's what I'm up to now.
It
probably explains why I'm not quite as accurate as what I was the last game.
In the inning. Lofted in the air,
get there, get there, get there, get there.
Bruce has a read on it, and that
finally. God, we should have. I can't believe it. We've had two runs scored against us.
Two errors in the inning, and two men left stranded. We'll move on to the bottom half of inning number one. The Braves lead it 2-0.
Two errors in the first inning of the entire game. Like, wow. So embarrassing.
Dan Plesak, what's the word on
we actually didn't make a single fielding error the other day, and now he's got to make two in the first half inning.
Whip coming into this start. One of the things he's going to have to do a much better job, keep traffic off the bases, keep the walks down, try to limit the amount of hits. He's had a rough go that so far this year. Let's see if he can turn it around in this one.
Come on, Jose.
Back to work as the shortstop. Wow. Jose Reyes digs in to lead off the bottom of inning number one.
God, I hate the slider. All right.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Takes a fastball on the inside corner. Guys, one of D-Rose's former employers, the Braves, as they begin play here this afternoon. They come in looking to make it two in a row as they were winners last time out.
Hey, thanks, Matty. Hey, you know what, D-Ro?
Trying to get
on kind of a little mini winning streak here. Losing the first game of this series, winning game two,
really,
and
late
hopefully
to that?
Winning this series by pulling one out here today.
Yeah, Dan, they were able to shower that first loss off in the first game of this series. Had a nice bounce-back game yesterday. Let's see if they can steal the series right here.
And that's out number one.
Thought I didn't hit that one too bad.
Here in
Maybe
Flushing
not.
Meadows, let's meet the Mets. Who stands out to you, Danny?
Well, Matt, I can't wait to
gosh.
See it.
Wow, was that outside the zone? I thought it was well in the zone. Never mind.
He's really had a heck of a year in the power categories. Slugging over 500 coming into this one. That means almost every time he's hitting the ball, he's hitting it hard somewhere.
Nice.
Boy, this guy's been swinging a hot stick lately. There's just another example.
Is that Frazier again?
Hit one on the barrel, he still manages another base hit.
Yeah, don't overthink it. When you're flowing like he is right now, he's hot as a pistol. Everything's falling.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch.
Gone. Adios, amigo. Good night.
Into the second deck and gone.
Man, I felt that one through the controller.
It's a two-run shot here for Yoenis Cespedes. Seven home runs.
Kaboom!
Here now, and the Mets have come back to tie this one at two.
Well, the two-run homer, that bounces things back up, well, back in our favor. Now Frazier's up. Damn.
As a fellow once said, the only park that that ball wouldn't have made it out of is Yellowstone. Everyone knows he's got plenty of pump in his bat, but come on, I'm not sure that ball's even come down yet.
What was the distance on that one?
Now. Career numbers against Julio Teheran. He's got three base hits in 16 tries. He also has one home run.
mph off the changeup. Wow.
First delivery
good
to
night.
Him on the way. Well hit the other way.
Oh,
and it's
come
into
on.
The
nice.
Game.
Extra bases. Go, 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 go.
Second goes Frazier. And he'll reach
nice.
Second now with one away.
Don't know why
one
he stops.
Dream inning is another team's nightmare, right? That's their third hit of this opening inning. This one a double. That's got to have the pitcher pretty upset out there.
I was,
the manager
yeah,
wondering
no, I
how long he's going to go in this.
I think I need to re-go through the controls because I've tried holding L1 down, which is to advance the runner. I've tried pressing it, like spamming it, like I was just then. It didn't quite work, but that was a well-hit ball. All right, here we go.
Here's Jay Bruce now. He'll go after the first pitch and bounce it into
Brucey,
foul
baby,
territory.
Come on.
And he's a
bit of a slump right now for Jay Bruce.
In a big way. Hasn't been getting the results he or his club.
He's actually like in the top 15 in the RBIs total in the National League, so he's not doing too bad.
Good lead off a second there. Now the pitch.
Oh, wow.
Swing and a little tapper, but it gets fouled.
That came down.
Frazier leads off second with one gone in the inning. On the ground to the right side. Oh, what a stop on the slide. He's out.
That's that right. We'll advance the man.
He got the out and prevented the runner from having a chance to score.
Well executed two-seamer on the outside corner that time, and that's what you'll get a lot of with that pitch. He rolled right over it.
Next for the Mets, Adrian Gonzalez, one of the better hitters in the game this year, currently seventh in the National League batting race.
Alrighty, here we go. Time to smash it.
Tehran sets. Here comes the first pitch.
Nope.
Missed with a slider.
Boy, that's a great breaking ball right there. That's a tough pitch to lay off when that ball's coming in at that plane right there. Quality take.
Now the 1-0. Fouled away. Fly ball out toward left.
Reach on it. Get down. Oh, what a play. God, I swear, the bloody Braves have made three really outstanding diving catches like that against us so far this year. One in each game, and that, wow, that's impressive.
And next will be Dansby Swanson digging in. Career numbers versus Syndergaard.
He's
gone 4-for-9.
Come on, Noah.
He's ready. Here's the first offering.
Honey.
High fastball is in there.
You know, Maddie, when I first broke into the league, you wouldn't see that high heater first pitch right out of the gate. But I think there's been a change in philosophy here. Back in the late 90s, early 2000s, guys wanted to attack you more east-west, get you leaning left-right. Now you're
seeing guys
attack in the philosophy more north-south. Just with launch angles and exit velocities, I think guys are afraid to throw that sinking fastball for fear that guys are just going to run their barrel into it. Not the case with the high fastball.
Good-looking sinker on the inside corner.
One ball, two strikes.
Inside and a hair low. It's two balls and two strikes.
Come on, Noah.
Here's the pitch on 2-2.
Never attempted
to swing at that ball down low. It's ball three.
You can bet they'd love ball four here. That gives the pitcher on deck an obvious bunt situation to move the runner into scoring position.
Yes!
It
was ball four, but he swung at it.
Okay, here's how the Mets are lining up defensively. And this team, they're not going to be moving around as much as some of the new age teams. The shifting and moving the third baseman over second base and the right fielder to play third base. This is going to be your stationary team, trusting pitchers to execute pitches.
The next to bat for Atlanta, Julio Tehran.
All right, pitcher on deck.
First offering on its way. Just a tick behind for a strike.
Yeah, Maddie, he's very late on that first pitch. I got to think he was guessing off speed.
The windup and the 0-1. Behind 0-2 now. One out, nobody on.
Actually, what happened to Bartolo Colon? Did he retire?
This is flared out towards second.
Nice.
And this will be put away easily for the out.
I totally forgot about that guy. Bartolo Colon. Who's he playing for now? Oh, he's been traded to the Rangers.
He's 0 for 1
after
grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far.
Oh, wow. He's been at the... He got traded ages ago. Wow. I've totally been away from things.
Here's the pitch.
My God, he's been with three clubs since he's been with us. So he went to the Braves, then the Twins, and now he's at the Rangers. Wow. How old is he? 44 years old and he's still pitching. God. That's impressive. Don't even think I'll be able to walk at 44 years old at this rate. How freaking screwed my body is from all those years in motorsport.
There's a strike.
You would think racing cars is just like driving a car in real life. It doesn't really take much, but
bases are empty
in
here with
karting especially, your back is just ruined. And your sort of ribs are ruined.
And, that one just
and then racing in an open wheel car, your neck's ruined and your back's still ruined again. It's just, it takes it out of you a lot. I mean, it's like footballers, except footballers, it seems to be more legs and whatnot. But if you ever see like a 70-year-old ex-racing car driver, they're always hunched over like they're wearing some brace or something. But Bartolo Colon, I can't even pronounce his name properly. For him to be pitching at 44 years of age, man. I swear, when he retires, he may as well just amputate his right arm.
Two out, nobody on.
Pointless even having it. It'll be so worn out.
Swing and a line drive. Nice.
Find
the shortstop's glove for the third out.
So 46 pitches in two innings. That, well, there's absolutely no way Syndergaard is going to the end today.
26 at bats. He's also gone down on strikes five times. And Cabrera's going to have himself a base hit. So that puts the leadoff man aboard to get the inning underway.
Well, as Jubil, he was all over that fastball. That's what we like to refer to as a little bit of an ambush. Oh, heater gets turned around.
First pitch on its way. Very weakly on the ground. But it's foul, strike one. On its way, the 0-1 pitch.
Wow.
And a miss way behind on that one. The big fastball.
Man, I know exactly what this guy's feeling at the plate. Here we go again. Every time you're struggling, you look up and it says 0-2.
Ah, you bitch.
Freeman in foul ground.
Wow, that must have gone miles in
the air. First out of the inning.
All right, the Atlanta Braves attack you on defense this way. And how fortunate are we that we get to watch
pretty much timed it all right, just
center field today.
High strike once again.
Every highlight reel on the regular.
Really struggle to hit the
defense, saving runs,
to pitch against me, we have to do is put it somewhere up here at the top of the
on fire. This one should be fun.
Checked his swing
put
there
in the top
and
of the
no,
zone
not, says the third base umpire, ball two.
All right, here we go, sack fly. I mean, sack
punt. Runners off for second, wanting to avoid the double play here as he gets this one down. And you can't ask for much more out of a pitcher than that. The sacrifice works to perfection. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Jose Reyes, runner in scoring position with two gone.
Come on, Jose, run him in.
First offering on its way. Grounded to first.
Ah, fucking
Freeman
hell.
Is up with it, and he'll step on the bag himself and the...
Wow. God, that's embarrassing.
Welcome back to daytime
all right.
Baseball on the show.
Pitch number 421.
Thanks for joining us. Right fielder, now here's the pitch. Too high that time.
Come
with
on.
The first pitch, hits ball one.
Hit the zone. Far out. I cannot hit the zone.
And
God, even that went outside.
2-0. Bouncer up the middle. Right there is Reyes.
Finally.
Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third.
Very nice.
Once again, Freddie Freeman. He singled and scored in his first appearance in this one. First delivery to him on the way.
Hit that. Yes.
There's a fastball on the inside corner.
That's what you want.
Bases are empty, one man out.
Oh shit, this is gonna be interesting. Please don't hit him. Please don't hit him.
A ball and a strike now to the Braves first baseman.
Good pitch, good take.
Pitch and a great take there. There's not a lot you could do with that slider breaking down, and unless you can catch it way out front and hook it down the line, you see a lot of swinging misses on those.
Come on.
Two balls and a strike to Freeman. Now the 2-1 pitch. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Cespedes is after it. He gets there, and that's the second out.
On the warning track, I don't like that. Come on. Sort it out.
The Atlanta number 4 hitter, Tyler Flowers. 0 for 1 for him here in this one.
Atlanta no 4. Here we go.
Here's the first pitch to him.
God, we're only in the third inning. This game is going to go forever.
In front of a great slider that time.
Love it. Love it, love it, love it. Come on, Noah.
Takes
oh, money.
Fastball for a strike.
No balls, two strikes.
The wind
on,
up
hit
and
that
the
corner.
0-2 pitch.
Hit that corner.
Bouncer.
Oh, it hit
that
the corner,
foul,
but he got
so
it.
So a good job to fight it off and stay alive.
Let's go, Mets.
A ball and two
oh,
strikes
God, that
to
was
count
horrible.
To Tyler Flowers.
It's a great job to lay off on that nasty slider right there. It's the toughest pitch. It was my toughest pitch to lay off of. I was always hitting
nine.
Fastball middle away.
Got him!
Swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. Braves are...
All right. Change sides.
Next up from New York,
Juan
Lagares. Singled and scored in his first appearance in this one.
Juan Lagares.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Hit
out
to a second.
Rolled over on it.
And the
God
throw
damn it.
First is in time.
No, wait, wait. Allah, damn it.
So one gone now as we give you a look at where these two teams find themselves entering play.
I was outside.
National League's Eastern Division race.
Time
first
to smash
delivery
it.
To him on the way. And a
nope.
Neck-high fastball that time.
That's a good take on that fastball there. You know he's looking for something up there to drive, but that was just a little above his happy zone. Not everyone has the discipline to hold back on those.
Hit hard
to
third,
2 for 2.
Find its way into
fortunately, we won't get it over the ropes this time, but
so he finds
one
the
down.
Into left to pick up his second base hit of the
very nice.
As we check out the top
come on,
Todd. In that department, you can currently see he's third best on the ball club. First pitch of the at-bat. And he goes with the pitch here and drives it the other
good
way.
Good night.
Back goes Markakis. See you later. Over the wall, a home run.
Woohoo! That's the second double home run. Well, two-run home run, I should say.
Two-run homer that time for Todd Frazier. Fourth home run for him on the season.
I wasn't sure about that one, but it made it.
4-2 lead.
Definitely wasn't crushed like Cespedes one was, but that still feels just as good. Nice. Very, very nice. Well, it's been a while since we hit a homer, but we've hit two in the first three innings now.
Well, he's given up two long balls in just 2 1/3 innings of work. So it seems as though they might
have
they're
going to have to get
here.
Him off the
not
mound
sure
here in a minute.
More the manager wants to see. He needs to turn it around quick if he wants to stay in this one.
All right, come on, Jay. Add to the pile, mate.
Jay Bruce now.
Oh, maybe not.
On the ground.
But he'll get on base against the shift as well.
It's through for a base hit.
Hey, some guys
God,
look out
finally.
There, and they don't care. They can't execute
finally
the
some
the
luck.
Way. It's not that easy.
I have not been able to get this guy on base at all. I've managed to get two RBIs out of him in the last game,
you know,
but that's about it.
When you've come up all the way through high school, little league, college ball, the minor leagues,
nice.
And you're used to pulling the ball, that's the type of hitter you are. Some of these hitters are going to have to try to make some changes.
Well, he hit that at 106. No wonder they couldn't get on top of it.
Here's Adrian now. as he will look at a first pitch fastball.
I don't know, this
one.
Guy is just really easy to. I can see him out of his hand really well. Right handed pitches.
Count, here it is. A fastball that just misses.
Saw both
inside.
Of those.
Bruce leads off first.
Either that or I'm just on top of it today. Struggled the other day, only grabbed three. Oh, crushed.
On the move is Markakis.
Oh,
he
gets wow, okay,
there
maybe not.
Makes the play for the second out of the inning.
The way it left the bat, it's so hard to judge because you can't really feel how you hit it through the controller, but I felt like I nailed that one, and the way it left the bat, it's just going straight away from me, but obviously not. Yeah, no, got under it. Alright, come on, a dribble. Nailed, but nailed right to the second baseman. Alright, here we go. Time to get back on the mound. Big two-run home run. Another one.
And that'll bring in
deja
the
vu from the second
prospect,
inning.
Ozzie Albies looking to follow up the RBI single from his first at-bat.
Hey, we're still in the early
right, come
stages
on,
of
Noah.
This one. They're only down by a couple of runs. But it's
dangerous.
Really key for this leadoff guy to try to
dangerous.
Get on and get a big inning started.
These are huge innings for a team's morale. The pitcher wants to go out and throw that shutdown inning up and get the boys back
nice.
Swinging the bats again with a chance to capitalize. And
can't hang about with Ozzie. He's got 81 pace, so got to get that thing to first without any delay, which Frazier does.
Into the box,
Lane Adams.
He singled his last time up. Ready to deliver.
Pretty much cold
here's
everywhere
the
in the zone.
And that one right down Main Street.
We're moving along in this one, heading into the middle innings. This guy continuing to pitch well, and one of the reasons why, first pitch strike ratio over 70% up to this point in this game.
Good take.
1-1 the count. The 1-1 home. Is taken
oh,
for strike
God, that's
two.
Dangerous.
Can't say he's tickling around the zone. Those last two pitches were pretty much grooved right down the middle, but it didn't bite him.
And he lays off the fastball away, so it's 2-2 now. Two runs, four hits.
Swing,
and
butter.
No errors so far for Atlanta.
Just please swing at this.
Hit down the third baseline.
Oh, good take. Come on, get him, get him, get him, get him.
Throw
oh,
won't be in time as he reaches it first.
It was so at least he got the
Nero,
stop.
You make a good pitch and you get these guys that can run around and they're fast. You think you have an out and all of a sudden it turns into
a that was
a
tough
single.
Take. At least
yeah,
we stopped him from getting
part
extra
of his
bases.
Game, the ground attack, Dan. He's a speedster. He's going to get a ton of infield singles, and he knows how frustrated that pitcher is.
Shit.
Sinking liner toward left, and that'll get down for a base hit.
Boy, D-roll, that
wow, okay, we're in trouble now.
Hard, but when you're struggling like this guy is, any knock is a good knock.
Yeah, 100%.
He lucky to find the gap there.
He has to square it up mid-barrel to find a way to get a knock. He hasn't had much luck this year, but he'll take that anyway.
Comes right after.
How many have we got out? One, okay.
He's 0 for 1 thus far.
Really need.
Ready with the
0-1. Need a strikeout here.
In the dirt here. And he is
wow.
in there. They couldn't get him at second.
Super
so
delayed reaction there.
Position. We're in the fourth inning of a 4-2
fuck.
Ball game.
Now we are in trouble. Don't leave anything over the plate.
And that one stayed too low, apparently. Popped him up.
Oh, yes. Come on, come on. Get
Gonzalez.
There, get there, get there, get there.
Room in foul territory.
Yes!
And he brings it
all right, we need to strike out all that. And we got that. Come on. Just
so
pop it up.
Stepping in, Julio Teheran, as he'll look
pop
to
it up for me.
That tying run
oh, it's a pitcher as well.
With a base hit into the outfield. First pitch coming. Here it is. Lifted down the
nice.
Line
come
in
on,
left.
Get there, get there, get there.
Ligares is under it.
Do not drop this.
He's got
yes.
it, and that'll get him out of the jam. Oof.
Still 72 pitches
so striding
in just four
Travis
innings.
Garneau.
That's crazy.
That didn't go his way as
that's
he popped out in foul territory.
One of the keys to securing a win, they want to keep the pressure
how many
on
have we
and
taken?
Try to build that lead as much as they can moving
30.
Into the later innings.
So we've thrown twice the amount of balls
for him
they
so
have.
Far on the mound. Four runs and only three innings, so it'll be interesting to see
runs,
if he can settle in at all. And
he must be doing something, right?
Or if this start will continue to run downhill.
Digging in to try it again.
Now just smash it.
He did his job and laid down the successful sack bunt in his first appearance. Line to the right side.
Oh, he's okay, so we had a game last week. I can't remember who it was against, but we got three hits in one game from Syndergaard, the pitcher. Three hits in one game. He was 3-for-4. Sorry, 3-for-3 at the end of the game. Like, how is that even possible? I mean, it's a pitcher. I mean, I know some of them can actually hit, but that was just wow. And he's just done it again.
Here's the shortstop now, Jose Reyes.
And now he's going to be up to scoring position.
And that's through for a hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
You know, as a former infielder, Danny, they always say you can't
come
be
on,
in two places at once, but you got to be a little frustrated right here that ball found the hole.
Yeah, that's a tough thing. Make a quality pitch.
Oh, money.
The right.
Hold on now. That ball is down and could score a run. And this will be off the wall out near the 330 marker.
Oh wow, I got him out. Fuck.
But they do play to run on the play.
All right, fuck. I did not think they were going
to
get that. Well.
Oh well. Back in the opening frame.
Come on, Yoenis, just fucking send it.
Every team has that one guy, and Yoenis Cespedes is that guy for the Mets. Completely changes that complexion.
5-2 though.
He's certainly giving up plenty of hits in this one, but the funny thing is he hasn't walked anyone yet. That tells me he's throwing strikes, but he's just not throwing enough quality strikes.
One and one, here it is. This is
toward
left center. Adams giving
chase.
He gets
got under
there
it.
To make
I felt
the
it.
Catch, and that ends.
Oh well, we got another run out of it, so
here's
up by three now. Just
out in
more sort of more of a breathing, or more breathing room, more of a gap. Safety
here's
zone, whatever you want to call it.
Oh, and there's a pitch that just misses the inside corner.
I totally forgot that I upped the difficulty, so it totally makes sense to me now as to why I'm struggling to be so accurate, especially with Syndergaard of all people.
Into his
windup,
here comes the 1-0.
Easy top five best pitchers in the league.
That's inside, 2-0.
We haven't actually given up a run.
The
only two
the
runs we've given up are due to errors, so.
Outside, 3-0 now.
Come on.
Not the way you'd like to start
hit
this fifth inning, falling behind 3-0 on the count. It's about time he starts throwing some strikes.
And a good comeback there. It's 3-1. Set to deal. Here's the 3-1. Oh, this one bounces
off
the pitcher. But
nice.
He is able to recover as he gets the out at first. One away now. And
lucky.
Got him. And it appeared from up here at least, and his actions on the field confirm it. It looked like it got him on its drive leg, which could be problematic, of course, for him. But from the way he's trying to walk it off, I think he's going to try to continue. Nick Markakis stands in for the third time now as he takes a look at a ball. It's 1-0.
Come on.
And
money.
He looks at a changeup in there, 1-1. The 1-1 is in there for the second strike.
Strike two. One and two.
The 1-2. He pulls this one into right.
Oh, what are you doing? Oh, fuck. Just ran to the right and scared the shit out of me. Oh, God. I hate it when they do that. Jesus. Oh, that was scary.
Ready for another shot now. Freddie Freeman, a hit in two tries so far.
Stop doing this to me, MLB. Far out. You're killing me, Smalls.
First pitch
on
its way. Sent on the ground out the second and that is through into right field for a single. So the two out base hit and the top of the inning is still alive.
That is so depressing when this happens.
Got his bearings there. Dan was going to have a 1-2-3 inning, but not the case, giving up that late two out knock.
Boy, this lineup is so deep, 1-9, they could put a hurting on you, and they're making him work, and he's given up a lot of base hits so far in this one.
So far, this has not been an easy one for this pitcher.
Nice.
Swing and a miss here, and he's behind in the count now, 0-2.
I'd be shocked if you saw anything else but a fastball right here. He's blown those first two by him. Don't give this guy a chance to speed up his bat with something off speed.
One ball and two strikes to count. The 1-2. Just hung in there on that one. The 1-2. Down the third baseline.
Oh, my God.
But this is a foul ball as the...
Going to the bullpen already. It's depressing. Oh, come on, swing it.
Pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. We're in the fifth inning here. 5-2 is our score. Hold this one in the air out to left. Ligares is under it. No trouble with this one. And
all right, too easy. Come on.
Trying to pick things up where we left off.
Top Brazier. They always look, they got the same sort of body style. Body stature.
Now, that last one wasn't exactly a tape measure shot, but listen, a home run is a home run. I know a lot of pitchers, they call that a wall scraper in his last AB, but listen, it counts as a home run nonetheless.
And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
I mean, yeah, I could take more strikes, but he's throwing so many of them, and they're right over the plate as well.
This is
like that.
So he'll add one.
And that's why, although I've struck out and popped out a couple of times, you know, we've got five runs on the board out of 40 pitches.
In their half of the fifth.
Damn, with that single, he's now three quarters of the way to hitting for the cycle.
I mean, so like, technically, one in every eight pitches we're getting runs out of. Suppose you can look at it that way.
Right down the line, or one of those tweeners in the gap. He has enough speed, so he can find a gap or find one down the line. Maybe he can do it, and he's going to at least get one more at bat in this one.
He's set, and the pitch. Now a shot toward the gap in left center. And they've really got something
going
here. Probably
could have gone for home there, but I'm not going to try it.
That
was a good throw as well.
The good news for pitchers in this park is
that it
doesn't give up many home runs. A lot of room in the outfield. Sometimes that's the bad news as well, though.
New pitcher on the deck. I mean, new pitcher on the mound, so.
And to go for extra bases.
All right,
just like that.
Have to see a couple here.
Into the box, Adrian Gonzalez. He swings and grabs it to short. Throw to first is in time, but meanwhile, the runner is in to score.
Sack RBI.
Digging in once again, Asdrubal Cabrera.
Wow, he went with a changeup. Interesting.
First pitch of the at bat on its way. And a fastball misses here to start the at bat. It's 1-0. Ready with the 1-0 pitch. That's wide, 2-0.
6-2. Well, we're on top of them today.
Out there right now. That's common with hard throwers like him. Running a blazing fastball up there is great, but if you can't harness it, what good does it do?
3-0.
3-0 now. Six runs.
See if we can get a walk. I'm just not gonna bother swinging at these next two. Take a couple of pitches.
And that
on deck. Wow.
So with one out, that
I mean, on bait.
Set up
my English today has been useless.
Get them out of the
getting all the way. It's so hard switching between so many different sports like I do in. From motorsport back to sport, back to motorsport. I always get my terminology mixed up. It's so bad when I go from bikes to cars. I always go from, like, I'll be in a MotoGP race and I'll say, oh, we drove really well today. Like, no, you didn't. You didn't drive at all.
Try to check it, and it's 0-1.
I didn't actually try to check that. I tried to swing at that. For some reason, it checked it for me. Well, probably would have rolled over the top of it anyway.
From the stretch. And
get
he
down,
him
get
up.
Down.
Freeman trying to get there. And this is going to get down. It's a foul ball. And here's a fastball on 0-2, but it misses. 1-2 now.
Come on.
Boy, it's hard to sit on an 0-2 fastball. I think that pitch just locked him up a bit. But lucky for him, it was just a little out of the zone.
There's one. On to Freeman, and they turn the double play to
end
the inning.
Well played.
Ready once again, Ozzie Albies. He'll start things out against Noah Syndergaard as this inning is underway. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Takes a knee-high fastball. The 0-1 on its way. Little chopper back to
nice,
the mound.
Nice, Syndergaard.
Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth.
I swear that's like the third time that Aussie guy's done that.
Digging in once again, Lane Adams. Two hits and two trips for him thus far. Here's the first
I know he's getting tired. He just needs to last one more inning.
Now a ball bounced foul near Wash.
Third base coach
Ron Washington. One out, nobody on. At third, here's Frazier. A dive and he knocks it down.
It's all right. Probably could have got to that. I don't know why. I just, for
ready
some
for
reason,
shot
had the instant you're reaction to dive at it.
Last time through was right. A base hit. He's ready. Here's the first offering.
Ah.
And that one stayed too low, apparently. Looking at
nice.
A fastball for a strike on the corner. The 1-1. This is hit the other way out toward left field. There to pull it in, Lagares, and there are two away now. And he will scurry back to first as he'll think twice about trying to move up. The next to bat for Atlanta, Dansby Swanson. He flew out in his last at bat. Here comes the first pitch. Outside with the fastball, that's 1-0. And he fouls this one off. Adams, the runner at first with two gone. Swinging a soft liner.
Nice.
This won't get past the glove right. Of Reyes at short.
That will be the last inning for Syndergaard. Yeah, we'll bring Nimmo on. Why not?
Brandon Nimmo is going to come off the bench as he'll be asked to lead off the bottom of inning number six. Nimmo! There's a fastball that just misses, ball one. Now the 1-0. Reaches out for one and hits
God
it on the ground to second. Albies brings it in, throws in time, and that's out number one. One away now for the Mets in the sixth, and the lineup turns over now for Jose
Come on,
Reyes.
Jose.
Ready to deliver, here's the first pitch. Swing and a liner.
Nice.
A leap, but he can't bring it down. Base hit.
Another hit for Jose.
Pulling the trigger on that 0-0 pitch. I can't imagine that's exactly what he's looking for. The result works. The pitcher can't be too mad.
Here's Juan Lagares now. He's got a base hit tonight. That's a strike to throw down.
Another steal.
And it's not in time, so Reyes has himself a stolen base. Now a spin and a throwback to second, and he's back in standing. Runner at second here with one man out.
All right, come on. Oh, wow.
Behind 0-2 now.
That was weird. Sort of glitched halfway to the zone.
Here it comes, 0-2. Breaking ball.
Wow.
And he gets him to chase it in the dirt. Makes the throw to first. Two down.
All right, we'll advance Jose to third, so all we need is to get a hit.
Yoenis Cespedes will stand in here, but before he does, let's take you back to the very first inning. This was a two-run home run right out of the gate that really got these guys off to a fast start. No balls and a strike to count. High in the air down the right field line. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball.
Come on.
High and deep to right center. Ranging back is
that not seriously another one?
But he won't get
there
as it lands just shy of the wall. And the runner scores from third as
nice.
They extend their lead. And he's safe.
I thought that was going to be another one. So he's had one homer and three RBIs in one game. Damn.
And that base hit right
here. Yoenis Cespedes, that is why he is our franchise hitter.
You drive to the park every day hoping your rhythm and timing is on point with that pitcher's windup.
All right, come on, Todd.
That's exactly been the case today. He not only mixed in that big
just
bomb,
smash it.
But now he's got three ribbies to boot.
Gone! Good night, power swing. Three home run, well, two run home runs in one game, 404. Second home run today. Wow. I didn't realize it was him that hit the one earlier today. Wow, after an early season slump, he has just come and smashed this thing out of the park. Hot damn. 9-2.
That's one of those pitches you wish you could take back as soon as it leaves your hand. But guess what? There are no delete or rewind buttons in baseball. That's a mistake, and it was a good job by his opponent to make him pay for it.
Now batting. Here's Jay Bruce now. And he'll go after the first pitch to him and comes up empty. It's strike one.
Come on, Jay.
So far, 2-for-3 in this one. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-1. Curveball that time, not even close.
Well, this inning pretty much has been one to forget for him, but
come
he's
on,
still
Jay.
Out there. And it's only going to get worse if he dwells on it and lets the frustration take over. Easier said than done, though.
Change up. Too early.
Foul right at home plate. And he strikes
No.
So he's able to stop the bleeding a bit as the side is retired.
Just can't get that guy going.
But they strike for three in
however,
the inning, two on this two-run home run.
Three home runs in one game after not scoring a homer for like the last three games.
Rob Brantley.
Wow, this has been all right.
The bench as he'll pinch hit here to start inning number seven.
Rob Brantley. Now pitching for the
all right, Seth Lugo.
Fouled off. Brantley, the former Chicago White Sox. He was signed as a free agent in the middle of last season.
Yeah, I know he expected to get a longer term
nice.
Deal, but these are the facts right now. He is on a one-year deal, and he is going to have to produce if he is going to get that multi-year he's been looking for come offseason.
Nice.
Swung on and missed for the first out.
You ain't getting no multi-year on that.
Boy, there's nothing better from a pitcher standpoint than watching that high fastball, a high piece of cheese, swung at and missed. That pitch looks so inviting to hit, but it's awfully tough to put in play.
And he misses inside with that one. Ball one. Now the 1-0 is looked at off the plate for a ball. Bases are empty. One man out. And this will ricochet off of him on the mound. And they'll have no play as he reaches first base safely.
Man.
Here's Nick Markakis now, the right fielder. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. He's set. Here it comes. Change up.
Nice change up.
Well, if you could throw it for a strike consistently, a first pitch changeup is effective. Hitters are almost never looking for it.
Outside for a ball, 1-1. Ball
nice.
And two strikes. A ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. Swinging a ball line softly
damn.
Down the line and left. But this will be a Whee! Foul ball. Now another 1-2. And a fastball just a bit high.
This kind of hitter right here, we call this guy a grinder. What are our grinders? They just kind of foul off some good pitches. They lay off the pitches
on.
Just off the plate. This is every pitcher's nightmare, a guy that's up there with a plan and not just up there swinging at anything that you throw towards home plate.
Come
good
on.
Battle. Count remains full. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. He can only
nice.
For so long as he's finally set down here after an eight-pitch at-bat. Here's the first baseman, Freddie
Come
Freeman.
On.
He's 2-for-3.
Two down, one to go.
Here. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. And there's a pitch that just misses the inside corner. A ball and a strike now. Frazier trying to get there. And this is going to wind up a foul ball.
Hit someone.
Outside, 2-1.
Nine.
Lifted the other way down the left field line. Lagara's on the run.
Nice.
He makes the catch.
Juan.
Play on the run to end. Chase Whitley comes on to pitch.
All right.
Now.
New pitcher.
Results than the other arms.
See if we can make it 10.
In this one.
High score so far this year has been 9-4.
Adrian Gonzalez, 0-3.
Still
with
got
an RBI
two more innings.
In
well, one more at this rate. No. Two more. Okay.
From the stretch, here's the pitch.
Wow.
He jumps at a changeup, a swing.
Got me on that one. Eyes wide open there.
0-1, here it comes. This is on the ground over to first.
Ah. Damn it.
And he'll flip it to the pitcher covering for the
Dick.
So the leadoff man sat down.
What was that? Was that another?
Cabrera.
Wow, he's got a slow fastball.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Now he goes the other way.
Oh, come on, get out of here.
A lot of it high,
get out of here.
Deep to left center field. And it is trouble that finds the gap for extra bases. And he'll pull
almost
in the second
it.
With one away.
He obviously didn't
that was
let
a slow pitch though. So I just can't
his head too much because that's his second
can't
ball
get
game. This one, no.
The power behind
sure
it when it's only 81 miles an hour.
About the way he's going right now.
Here's the catcher Travis d'Arnaud.
Oops.
And a swing from him yields a foul pop out of play to the right. He's hitless in three at bats to this point. Now a look and a throw back to second, and the runner back in standing.
Ah, God, he really likes to change up this guy. Yeah, but wow, fascinating.
Here's the 0-2. Oh, and he can't
oh,
catch
wow.
up to the fastball as he swings and
God, this guy's got me going so good. I thought that was going to be a change up. That was a fail and a half. Who should we have a? Who should we let have a crack? David Wright.
David Wright will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number 5.
Time to smash it.
And this one runs up high. Ball 1. The 1-0.
Ah, fuck.
Ground out to second.
That should have been creamed over the frickin' fence. Wow.
Here in the 7th. One hit.
All right, vamos.
You're up. Now pitching for the Mets.
Ready for another chance? Tyler Flower. He could really use a knock here. 0-3 in the game so far.
AJ Ramos.
1-0-1.
Not a bad idea right there. Make this guy work and see if he can throw the ball over the plate. Throws the first pitch for a strike. They need to get some runners on base, and not a bad plan. Unfortunately, the pitcher came in with a strike on the first pitch.
Behind on
nine,
that
nine,
swing,
nine,
and
nine,
now
nine.
He'll try to shorten up maybe and protect the plate. The 1-2 is a swing.
Got
and a
him.
Strike 3. Now batting, Ozzie Albies. He was a ground out victim last time up. First pitch of the at bat on its way. And a fastball just below the knees, ball 1.
Ah.
One out, nobody on. Fouled
away. Come on. Some good opening pitches here from Ramos. Keep it up, keep it up. Ugh. God, these Braves like to battle.
To two balls and two strikes now.
Tough to take a pitch like that right there, especially in a 1-2 count. You almost get in that auto swing mode. Great
get
job
it, get
to
it, get
work
it.
The count back to even.
Reyes on
get,
to the
oh
grass.
My God.
Two gone.
Whew. All right.
Digging in, Lane Adams. He's ready. Here's the first offering.
Oh, ah, damn. Good take.
Here comes the 1-0. takes a high fastball for a strike. Bases are empty here with two men out.
Come on.
Misses 2-1.
Looks like he's pitching pretty cautiously right here, but that happens when a guy's 3-for-3 on the day. Usually he's a guy you challenge a little bit more, but I guess he's earned some respect in this one.
Come on.
Get it towards left center. Ligares is
all right.
Enough room out
there we go.
Puts this away to retire the side.
Down to the final inning.
Down in order go the Braves.
For the Braves, we still got a half inning left.
But now, Jose
it's looking
Ramos.
Good so far.
Been a 2-for-4
I doubt they're going to score
so
8
in
runs
in
one inning.
First delivery to him on the way.
Come on.
Just able to get a piece of that for strike one.
Guys, so slow. It's hard to adjust right now.
0-1, here's the pitch. Now a fastball off the plate away, a ball and a strike.
$100 says this one will be a changeup.
A ball and two strikes to Jose Reyes. With this one almost
$100 cheaper than what I was 10 seconds ago.
What are your thoughts on this offense, fellas?
Yeah, you ain't kidding, Matty. Dan, what does this feel like when balls are just flying out of the yard?
Hero, it's just one of those days when you're out there as a pitcher going, oh, I wish I was somewhere anywhere else but on that bump right now. This has the makings of being a long game.
Was that? Wow, that was miles outside. Lucky I caught that.
Popped him up.
Wow, you twallop.
And this is taken in for out one.
Threw like four pitches in a row outside the zone, and I hit every one of them.
Singles for him in four trips for him this afternoon. First pitch of the at bat. Hit on the ground to third.
Juan. I can't get this guy.
First, and there are two away now.
Come on. Come on, Yoenis. Just
digging
fucking smash it.
For more, Yoenis Cespedes. He launched one over the wall back in the opening frame. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes.
Nope.
And a neck-high fastball that time.
Let's go one more time, baby.
Swing and a miss just behind a live.
Thought I was
going to
get a change up there.
Hey, I get it. You're all in fastball. You're pulling the trigger at almost anything. That is way too high. He's going to have to lower his sights.
Hard on the ground towards And 8 innings have come and gone.
No home run there. Wow, that shows that you don't need pace to be a good pitcher. I mean, that was incredible. That's the slowest pitching I've faced all year. I could not get on top of it.
Odds of trying to come back in this one.
Yeah, not a lot of hope for them at this point.
But it's all right.
These guys know these bats
9 runs.
At least for their own stats, you can't mill in your chances.
Match the highest score so far.
The 0-1 pitch. And there's one well above the zone for a ball. And that one just missed outside. Ground ball sent back up the middle. That's through for a base hit.
They got a leadoff.
Second of the ball game. So it's an inning opening base hit, and the Braves have a man on.
Now batting.
And next will be Dansby Swanson digging in. Head to head against AJ Ramos. He's 0 for 5. And he'll power in a fastball that time at 94 for strike one. Set to deliver the 0-1. That misses wide. One ball and one strike.
Come on, yes.
Bold strike in a dangerous location there, 1-2.
Might have been taking all the way right there. That pitch couldn't have split the strike zone any better. And you can bet he wants that one back to the plate.
1-2 pitch is a slider that misses 2-2. Hard hit ball to second, and this is knocked down over there, and a good effort as he's able to gather it in and make the play for the first out. Kurt Suzuki will get a chance with a runner in scoring position here as he'll pinch hit now with one away.
Suzuki!
And the 34-year-old veteran looks at a called strike. It's 0-1. From the stretch. And this is high, a ball and a strike. Ready with the 1-1. hit back up the middle. Right there is Reyes. Spin throw.
All right, there it is.
First, the only play he had, and he made it a good one. So coming to the plate,
pretty good spin.
Ciarte.
All right, here we go. Last out.
Open, we'll see if they think about working around it.
One down.
The 0-1. And there's
oh, come
one.
On.
Camargo on third with two out. Pulled toward right
on,
center
get
field.
Get there.
Cespedes on the move. And he
yeah, boy!
Down. And this ball game is
woo-hoo.
Over.
9-2. Smashed it.
Is to win some games at home. So this was a big win to win at home in front of
three
home
homers.
A
9-2 three 2-run home runs. Two from Frazier, one from Cespedes. What a day out in New York.
Noah Syndergaard earns win number 4 on the season. Julio Teheran struggled and gets the loss after giving up 6 earned. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa.
That is swag right there.
I'm Matt Vaskirjian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way on over to theshownation.com.
So it was 16 hits in the end. We had 2 errors on the first inning, of which they scored 2 runs. But between then and the end of the game, it was a shutout. So we very well could have had a shutout today had we not made those fielding errors in the first inning. But the point is, we came back 4-for-4 from Todd Frazier. 2 home runs, 2 base, 1 double, but 4 RBIs, 3 runs, 3-for-5 from Cespedes, 1 homer, 1 double, 3 RBIs, 3 runs, 2-for-5 for Reyes, 2-for-3 for Drew Cabrera. So, all in all, an awesome game for us. Alright guys, thanks for tuning in. Stay tuned next week as we head back to the show for some more baseball. And also stay tuned over the weekend if you're into your NASCAR. We're heading over to Dover Speedway for the NASCAR iRacing Series, where hopefully we can grab another win like what we did last year at Dover. The Monster Mile should be fun.